I really don't know enough about the song.
In 1996, id Software offered gamers a new, exciting way to play and compete. That year marked the true birth of esports, and it began with a LAN party in Dallas, Texas. Fans came together to play a fast-paced, revolutionary new shooter called Quake.
Oh yeah, Quake.
It offered them a new way to compete, and the best of the best were finally recognized as professional gamers. This year, Quake Champions takes esports to the next level.
We weren't born champions.
Oh my god.
We're made.
They're doing what Blizzard did.
What?
Made better.
Asian pandering?
No, have you seen what Blizzard did?
Made faster.
Blizzard went for this esports thing for Heroes
made
of the
deadlier.
Storm. Like
with
a whole
every
league.
Single match. We don't just
where
play.
They do this thing
we
where
compete.
It's like, you make a name. Your name goes
we achieve.
Goes to local LAN party. Then you take it to the college, and then it's like pretty much going
we
like
a
montage
best.
Of like someone getting rising
until
up to the top.
We are Quake champions.
Okay, so it's like a progression.
Yeah, it's like they're doing that with
you
this.
You have to know like trigonometry and fucking geometry to do this shit very well.
Yeah, you gotta time everything.
Juice it up, baby!
Yeah, it's not the game for me.
Did you see that?
What's the matter?
I mean, I'm
lose
okay,
something?
But I'm
you'll
know
regret that.
Shields on.
Yeah, this is like a pro kind of game.
Try to keep up.
It's one of those games with like pro players.
Who's next? You've done messed up now.
I'm coming for you, goddamn weirdos.
Jeez, look at that.
None of you gets out alive.
They got some really good players to do the demo for this.
They did.
You win.
It all comes down to this.
This is the crazy
every
accuracy,
match,
you know?
Every frag. Every victory. More than 20 years in the making, the original esport returns. Announcing the Quake World Championships.
See?
August 26th at QuakeCon in Dallas, Texas.
QuakeCon?
Yeah,
competitors will face off in the ultimate esports arena to win their share of $1 million. And the one thing every champion seeks.
Go to those 15.
Legacy.
Dude, for the amount of skill it takes to play Quake, it should be higher than 1 million.
I mean, Dota does 15 million, if I remember.
Get ready for the Quake World Championships.
Even,
visit Quake.com to learn more.
Yeah.
Versus that.
No, they do like 10 million. It still is around that vicinity.
Some parts of Bethesda Land have been under construction, but now the work is nearly finished. Let's take a peek.
I wish that Valve had their own fucking... Like, oh yeah, not...
Is this the Evil Within?
Sebastian. For 3 years since Beacon happened, you've been searching for answers. You didn't find what you were looking for because... they didn't want you to. Mobius knows you've been following us. And they've been watching you for a long time. You trained and trusted me. And in return, I betrayed you. Long before we met, you lost your daughter, Lily. She's still alive. This is your chance to save her. To get back what you lost. Lily needs you. You're gonna need to go back into STEM.
I think this is the Evil Within.
he floating in milk?
And as I try to make my way to
the ordinary world, oh man, her eye was a shutter. Aperture. Oh my god. Half-Life 3. It is the Evil Within 2. Okay.
Oh, shit. I just can't remember if that was the guy's name. Oh, shit.
Of course, Friday the 13th. So that releases on Kim's birthday.
Wow. On Friday, October 13th, The Evil Within 2 will surely be giving us all nightmares.
The first game was pretty cool. For what it was.
We hope you've enjoyed your time in Bethesda Land. And as we near the end of our tour, we leave you with one more coming attraction.
Here you go, Peggy. There's everything your mother ordered and a ration card. And here's a Lockridge Necker just for you.
Wow. Gee, thanks, Mr. Wilson.
This is random.
Hi, Bill.
Looks like they're about to tell me drugs are bad.
Drugs are bad, okay?
I'm gonna get you out.
Get it off.
Hang on, I'm gonna get you out of here.
This is recorded like an old movie. Condition of last year's security.
Wunderbar soldier who ever lived. Power of
Thunder. Welcome back to round three. Now is where it gets really exciting on America's number one game show. General! Okay, hands on your buzzers. Here we go.
The Honorable, you must exercise self-control.
I think this is something where the Germans won.
Like, the Germans were trying to do experiments like that.
All the joy and pain.
Wait, is this Bioshock?
Second balcony.
Bioshock is 2K.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
But 2K doesn't exist. Go Dutch treat, you were sweet.
The old and the weak are doomed.
William, I prayed for you to wake up.
You've gotten so fat.
It says we're having twins.
Frau Engel, she's been hunting for you. She's been moving heaven and earth, and today she found you.
You think your hero, William Joseph Blaskovich?
Wolfenstein?
Possibly.
Monsters did this.
Not monsters.
Hey.
Have you taken
the
German lessons?
What the fuck? AKK and Nazis. Hello? And shit?
Come on, Peter, let's go someplace else.
Mom,
no
buts!
Oh! Bitte schön.
Danke. Come on.
You, one strawberry milkshake, please. Oh, I hope you don't have a fire back there to put out. If so, I'll come back another time.
I'm sure the fire can wait, Commandant. One strawberry milkshake coming right up.
Fireman, I recognize your face. Very Aryan face it is, too. Are you out of Station 1?
There you go, Commandant.
Oh, vielen Dank. Now you, show me your identification papers.
We gotta put the fighting spirit back in the American people.
We shoot good guys! Smile!
Just who the fuck are you, white boy?
Stay calm. Let me first make it absolutely clear that I am not a Nazi.
Wait, what you say? You say you're a Nazi?
Oh, fuck this.
Motherfucker!
Let me say this again. I ain't no goddamn Nazi.
Hey! Now you bring Super Special back in and you put him down right now, or I will shove this grenade so far up your ass.
Lady. I got precious little time for your bullshit. We've been trying to make contact with your group. We're organizing for a revolution in America.
We? Shit!
Dumbass.
Take cover!
Relax, man. It's just a dub.
Okay, so it was attached.
Dude, this game got me full attention the whole time.
Leader. Named.
You know, my mom
that guy
said,
never whack it.
Never trust a man can't handle his whiskey.
So
you sit right down, sit there, Billy, and
this is pretty
up.
Cool. I like the story element of this.
Now listen, Terry Billy, I respect your ambition, but there's nothing can be done no more. The world has sank into the crapper, and all we can do now is drink this whiskey and watch the vortex suck it all down.
Didn't expect your belly to be quite so yellow.
We stood up against the imperialist war machine of the United States of America and the greedy money men of Wall Street who was itching to send the children of the proletariat off to die in foreign lands so that they could be filling their coffers. It weren't their sons bleeding on the beaches.
I got kids on the way, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna raise them in a world run by these Nazi assholes.
You take freedom away from the American people, you're playing with fire. And I intend to pour some gasoline.
this is definitely a Wolfenstein.
Yeah.
But this is a cool take on Wolfenstein.
A very cool fucking take.
I've never been interested in the game. This is the first time I feel interested in it. You know? Holy shit, this is a big ass gun.
Yeah. It turns into.
Oh! That was satisfying. That was fucking cool.
It's dangerous here. You have to be so quiet.
Why would you ever take acid when you're about to go?
Yeah, I don't know, but this guy is probably an addict or something.
Probably.
That was really cool. I like that.
I said a couple of months ago that the thing that Machine Games was working on is fucking bananas, so now you know what I mean by fucking bananas. A lady pregnant with twins stabbing a Nazi while a guy is dropping acid is fucking bananas. We can't wait to show you guys more of Wolfenstein 2 and how it combines a compelling shooter with great story, unforgettable characters, and killer graphics with over-the-top action. So if you visit our booth this week at E3, you have a chance to go hands-on and begin the fight to rally the resistance in America against the Nazi regime.
That's
cool. In addition to Wolfenstein 2, we'll have hands-on for our VR titles, so you can play both Fallout 4 and Doom VFR.
I want to be
there.
You can
play Quake Champions and start practicing for that big $1 million prize pool at QuakeCon. Or you can try the Battlegrounds mode in the new Elder Scrolls Online Morrowind. Plus, we have hands-on for the new Heroes of Skyrim for Legends. Plus, a cool interactive experience for the Evil Within 2. Exclusive develop interviews, presentations, and a lot more.
There was
so
more.
We hope you're as excited for what we have coming in 2017 as we are. Again, a reminder, everything that you saw tonight will be out this year.
That's a really
be it
tight timeline.
Mobile or PC, console or virtual reality, shooter, horror, RPG, action, or
VR
strategy card game.
That would actually be
we believe
really
Bethesda
cool
will remain the place to go for the very best in video games. We hope you've enjoyed this evening's showcase. It's your passion and excitement that drives our teams to make something great, something exciting,
fucking passion and excitement,
something fun. If you're here at E3, we hope you'll come by the booth and say hi. If you're not here in LA, please keep checking Bethesda, where we'll have lots more to say about the games you saw tonight in the coming days, weeks, and months. And we thank all of you online for joining us. Please have a good night.
That was one short conference, son.
That was a really short conference.
I mean,
what time is
it? It was only 40 minutes.
So we just got okay. So, thoughts.
There's not a whole lot to go on. I mean, most of it was just revamping shit that they already have and then adding on shit. I mean, like, the only really new things are the Evil Within 2 and then fucking Wolfenstein 2.
Yeah. And, but Wolfenstein was really cool.
Wolfenstein does look really cool. I mean, I've never really played any of them. I always wanted to just kill Nazis. I just never really got
it. It was never appealing to me, for one, about playing Wolfenstein. But this
it
was
awesome being able to ride a fucking fire-breathing mech. That's pretty fucking
cool. And all the things that you could do, and the wow, I gotta admit, the story, especially with the comedy influences and stuff like that, that's more original than what there is today.
There's that comedic relief to kind of just be like, okay, take a breather. All right, because
it's not a freaking just a serious game.
It's not Batman v Superman. That's what it's not.
But what's cool about it that got me was like they had those jokes in there, you know, that shows like it can it's a more of a fun game than anything. Yeah. But you can still have a story. In which the story is pretty cool. It's the premise of what, at this day and age?
Or, yeah, pretty much this day and age, where would the U.S. be?
Or in the 50s.
It looked a little bit more ahead than the 50s.
No, I think it's the 50s. Just that they have like, you know, kind of like that resistance thing. Like, remember Resistance, the game?
Well, no, that fucking helmet he had, that's future tech. It's probably just that the Germans like classic.
Maybe. But all I gotta say is that, wow.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy, to be honest with you.
And then the Evil Within 2,
I was kind of confused.
I was kind of confused, yeah. But man, it got really cool when it got to the scary parts, like the actual monsters. I was like, dude, that would be terrifying for me.
It would be pretty terrifying, dude.
And then...
And it's like the whole dream montage, it's like I would have liked to see more gameplay instead of just like, here's a really well-cut trailer.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, and a confusing trailer at that, you know? But I think what got me the most about this was Doom VR and Fallout 4 VR.
Well, yeah. It's like Doom and Fallout 4 VR, those are going to be really cool. I mean, a lot of people are going to go ahead and get them, without a doubt.
Yeah, because they're completely new experiences.
However, like, what I want to know is, it's like, how big is the demographic of people who have an HTC Vive and also really like Bethesda?
Yeah.
I mean, like, I think that I hope that they're not going to go ahead and shoot themselves in the foot and dig too much money into this for something that people don't want to have to replay.
Right, I get what you're saying. If anything, I think I was really hoping for a new Elder Scrolls game. I think I was going a little bit overboard with that. I know. I mean,
it took them forever just to come out with Skyrim.
It's just, I have hope. I have, and I know that it's just a little, some people might think that, like, why are you holding on to something you're not even
sure
of? You have
enough hope to have a big S on your fucking shirt, dude.
Well, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, if I don't feel that way, then I'll just be cynical about things. And I don't like to be negative about it.
Right.
So, hopefully maybe next year we'll get an announcement. But for now, that's good enough for me.
Right.
And I have to admit, it's not astounding like last year. Last year was crazy. But I think they didn't want to go too far because Fallout 4 was their biggest thing last year.
And that was a little overhyped.
Yeah. It was way overhyped.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's still a good game. It's just it's a disappointment.
It could have
still
been done better.
Yeah, it could have been way better.
Okay. And then, so, when's the next conference at?
10.
Okay. So, we have about 15 minutes until the next one. We'll go ahead and see you guys then. For now, this has been Panda.
And Mark.
All right.
See you in the next showcase. Minute.